In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use nonlinear regression to determine kinetic parameters from kinetic data. And the actual calculations, I'm going to use polymath because it's a very flexible program that allows us to do more complicated nonlinear regression problems. The situation we're going to look at is we have kinetic data that we obtain using a continuous stirred tank reactor. So to accomplish this, what we do is we change the inlet volumetric flow rate, V0. We keep the concentration in that stream constant, and we measure the concentration at the outlet. And with a mass balance on CSTR, we can then directly obtain the rate of reaction in the CSTR. And the mass balance, we're at steady state, so we'll pick a number of different steady state conditions. So steady state means volumetric flow rate in times the concentration of our reactant in. That's a molar flow rate in. The volumetric flow rate out is going to be the same for this liquid phase system. Concentration is going to be different. And it's going to be different because we have reaction. So we can rearrange this equation to say the rate of reaction. I'm going to write this with a minus sign, as we'll see why in a few seconds here. This is the equation. I'm going to call this the rate of reaction. So this is positive. CA0 is greater than CA. And what we're going to obtain is data in the number of conditions. So what I've listed here is the concentration. This is the concentration of a reactant A. So some reaction of A goes to B. And this is our experimental rate. And we don't have to worry about units. But we got this rate by measuring the concentration for the different volumetric flow rates. What we want to do is determine how does the rate depend on the concentration of A in some power law expression. So we want to determine the value of K. This is the rate constant. So at a given temperature, and everything we're doing here is isothermal, it's a constant. This is the order of reaction, first order, second order, etc. And the way we're going to do this is we're going to guess values. So we'll guess K and N, and then we'll calculate from this rate expression what rate we get. So for example, I'm showing the same data again. And then I guess K is 0.02, guess first order, N equals 1. I then calculate it, and you can see it varies, and as we get to the higher concentration, varies significantly, so that's certainly not the right guess. So what we'll do is use an iteration. And the iteration says, let's take the difference, R experimental minus R calculated, square it for each of these concentration values, and we'll sum all these, and this is what we want to minimize. We square it because sign should not be important as to whether the calculate rate is higher or lower than the experimental rate, and we want to have the minimum by having all of the calculated values close to the experimental value. And we're going to use a regression technique to do this. This is nonlinear regression. And the program that we'll use is polymath, a very robust program that allows us to do more complicated problems. Put values in the program, and we'll use a separate video to demonstrate how to use the program. Then here is the output from the program. Showed our initial guess. The answer says that our rate, 0.0859 times the concentration of A to the 1.48 power. 1.5 order is certainly a reasonable result for these data. Gives us confidence limits, number of other properties. Also shows here now is our measured value, our experimental value. Here is the calculated value. And now you notice the values are much closer than showed earlier. This is the difference between the two. This then allows us to take kinetic data we started out with and determine order of reaction and rate constant from kinetic data.